Hello and welcome to my channel. I'm going to teach you how to draw inside a particular shape. I'll also be covering a little bit about the watercolor brushes and the splatter, ink splatter brushes. So let's start. Go to File and New. Let's select 8x8 inches and click Create. Head over to your ellipse tool. If you can't find the ellipse tool here, right click and select the ellipse tool. Now click and drag to make an egg-like pattern, or it could be even a circle, doesn't matter. Now hit V on your keyboard or head over and select selection tool. Hold your option key down, click and drag. When I say option key, Windows users should use the Alt key. So hold your Alt key down, click and drag. So let's place these two eggs on our canvas. Let me just make the rest of the background white as well. You can do that by going to View and Overprint Preview. Okay, let's use this one to show you how to draw inside a object. And we'll use this one to show you how to use the watercolor brushes and the ink splatter brushes. Let's go ahead and check this. I don't want a border right now, so I'm gonna uncheck this. And the white color, we can keep it as it is. Now, you see three options over here. This one says draw normal, and the one is draw behind, and the third one is draw inside. Click on draw inside. Now you see a dotted box around your object. That means that this object is selected and anything you draw inside it will stick only to inside. So I'll go ahead and select my brush tool. Select the charcoal feather option. It can be any brush, it doesn't matter. And now I'm gonna go ahead and select a color, maybe pink. That's because we had our circle selected and then we clicked on pink, so it got selected as well. Let's undo it, click Ctrl Z or Command Z. Now it's white, that's fine. Click outside. You cannot see it, but it's still there. As long as you have this dotted rectangle right here, it means that your object is selected. Click on the paintbrush tool, select your paintbrush, click on a color. I have some problem with my creative cloud, so I cannot use these colors, they are not syncing. So for this, we're going to use the colors which are available in Illustrator. If you cannot see the color panel, go to Window and Color. All the items which are on your right area right here, they're all available under the Window option. So if there's anything that you cannot see here, just go to Windows and click on it and you can see it over here. So color, let's choose some color. Make sure you are selecting the outline stroke and go ahead and select a color. I'm just gonna make sure this is more pink. Okay, that seems fine to me. And I want the stroke to be a little thicker, maybe 4. So I'm gonna make arches. Okay, there you go. So this is what I mean. Now we can change the color and let's make it a little purple. Okay, and now I'm gonna do again some arches. Okay, so and then let me do a bit here so that we have a nice edge over there. So this is basically how you draw inside an object. And once you're done with this, go head over to your select tool, click on this draw normal, and then it gets unselected. But just to let you know, if you want to change colors or anything after you've done this, if you click on this, you won't be able to do that because it becomes one object. So, but you can still edit it. That is by you have to click on those certain elements so that it goes into the isolation mode and then you can change it. For example, let me click on this stroke right here, double click this. So now you can see that it's in layer one and it has gone into a clip group. So now I'm going to double click it again. And now you can see it's gone into that particular part, that is this path. And now if you want, we can change color. Like for example, I can make it yellow or green. And then all you have to do is go back and then you'll have it on your object. So that's how you have to change colors or edit objects. But yeah, this is your really nice egg with design inside. So now the next egg, we're going to do the exact same thing. Then we're going to select the draw inside option. Oh, we forgot one major thing. I'm gonna undo this one. I'm gonna take out the border because I really don't want the border. Now I'll go ahead and select draw inside. Now we'll choose some watercolor brushes and then try some ink splatter technique to draw this egg. Now all you have to do is click outside so that you don't have your circle selected, because if you do, then you know what happened last time. So once you have that, go click on your paintbrush and then click on your brushes. There's a small brush libraries menu over here. Click on that and go to artistic and artistic watercolor. Artistic watercolor menu opens up. They have different kinds of brushes over here, so you can select anything that you want. I'm just going to go with watercolor stroke 5. Once you have that selected, you can go ahead and choose any color you want. Probably let's keep it red. We don't have anything in red. Now that you've selected your color, make sure it's the stroke and not the fill. So I'm just going to swap it and then make the fill as none. Now your stroke is red. One thing you need to remember is that watercolor brushes are not very vibrant or bright. They are really toned down. Bright colors might. So I'm just going to make tiny swirls. It's not necessary that it has to be uniform. It's just random things that I'm drawing. So we have some pattern right here. Now I'm going to go ahead and select some other color. I'm just going to go ahead and select ink, and then you can select ink splats. So that seems fine to me. So I'm just going to make a splat like this, but this is too light. I really don't want that color. I want something really dark. So I'm just going to take red, which I had chosen earlier, and make some splats. So you can use ink splatter brushes to do that as well. Click your selection key, make sure draw normal, and now you have your two egg patterns ready. You can do the same thing with a lot of other patterns as well. For example, if I draw an egg here, I'll just say no to the draw fill. Let's keep it white. And now I'm going to select draw inside, click on the selection tool, click outside so it's not checked. I'm going to take my pencil tool and make sure it's not ink splats and it's in basic. Swap this so that your stroke has a color. So let's make some fill shapes in here. So let's make a wave. I'm going to go ahead and fill this shape and make this as fill. So you have your random shape ready. Now I'm gonna take my pencil tool again and then make rounds. But I'm gonna color it a little darker. And now we'll make stripes here. Let's push this back. You can use your command and back button to push it back. I used command shift and open brackets to push it behind everything. And then let's make one here as well. Push this back as well, command shift and open bracket. Okay, so now you have your third egg ready as well. So now if you click on this and hold shift key and then increase the size, this is how it's gonna be. So one more thing, if you wanna change the shape of your egg, like I want something like broader, but I want this to be sharper, go ahead and click on the tool right here. You can press A on your keyboard to do that and click until you see these two handlebars. You can modify this by, make sure you keep it straight and move this towards. You can do the same thing here. I made something which is like, even if you change the pattern, design still remains inside the object, and you can this use this to make a lot of things, like for example a flower petal, or you know, anything you want. So this is basically how you use the draw inside an object tool, and it is very helpful in certain situations. So I really hope you liked this tutorial. If you did, please hit the like button and subscribe to my channel. And do visit my blog. I have a lot of freebies out there, and there are a lot of Easter freebies out there as well. So hope you have a fun week. Until next time, bye bye.